Welcome back to the vlog, and I'm really excited. I know, you're gonna think I'm crazy, but I'm really excited because I'm gonna be telling you about a new urine test. And okay, I'm a little bit of a geek, but this is exciting because we're talking about diagnosing bladder cancer, transitional cell carcinoma. If you didn't watch the vlog before, please go back. I'll put a link below. But that's where I talk about prevention, early detection of bladder cancer, and the umbrella term of urothelial carcinoma. So we're talking about cancer of the urinary tract, which for veterinarians has been a very frustrating cancer to diagnose because the tests aren't always great, and it often you have to go to surgery or a scoping procedure, cystoscopy, to get biopsies of the urinary tract. And sometimes it's hard to get a diagnosis or costly. And we now have a new urine test, which is really, really good. So I wanna tell you about some of the tests that are still gonna be part of the workup often for a dog with suspected urinary tract cancer, TCC, transitional cell carcinoma. And then I want to tell you briefly about this BRAF test because again, I'm really excited about it. So let's do it. Let's talk about diagnosing bladder cancer and the BRAF urine mutation test, or I should say BRAF mutation urine test. Either way, let's do it. So in the last video, I told you the common symptoms or clinical signs that we see for dogs with bladder cancer, that it often mimics urinary tract infections. So what's going to be the workup that you're typically going to get when you go into your veterinarian? So we're often going to run a urinalysis, and hopefully when they send it off to the lab, they're going to look at the urine sediment, the cells under the microscope as well. Often they're going to do a urine culture and sensitivity. And as I mentioned in the last video, many dogs will have a concurrent urinary tract infection, meaning they have a urinary tract infection and can still have bladder cancer as well. So they're going to get better on antibiotics, but that doesn't mean that it was just, you know, sadly, it's not just a urinary tract infection. Another really important test is imaging of the abdomen, especially the urinary tract. Usually we're talking about the bladder, but it may be to look at the urethra, maybe the prostate, sometimes radiographs, but I usually do prefer an abdominal ultrasound over radiographs or x-rays. And then cytology. The problem with cytology, you know, looking at those cells under the microscope, is they're not, it's not often diagnostic. So we've often really needed better testing and often have to go to biopsies. And like I mentioned in the intro, usually requires surgical biopsies or biopsies collected with cystoscopy under anesthesia can be quite expensive. So let's talk about that and some of the options. So let's talk about surgery for bladder cancer, because in general, if we can remove a cancer, that's a good thing because it removes it and we can submit it to the lab for biopsy for histopathology to make the diagnosis. The problem, the frustrating part with bladder cancer in dogs is the most common location is called the trigone. And this is this triangular area, this anatomic area of the bladder where a lot of the tubes where the urine is coming in from the kidneys and going out to the urethra, a lot of the cancers are growing in this trigone area, and it makes removing it with surgery very challenging because you would cut off these tubes. If it's at the apex of the bladder, that's going to be a great candidate for surgery because we can remove the tumor from that part of the bladder, submit it to the lab, get our diagnosis, and then usually do chemotherapy afterwards. But the ones that are in the trigone are very challenging, and so we don't often want to take those pets to surgery, and it would be great if we didn't have to take them to surgery to get biopsies and get a diagnosis. Cystoscopy is a less invasive way to get biopsies, but still requires, you know, advanced diagnostics, someone who's skilled in using cystoscopy and has the equipment to do it, and, you know, still requires anesthesia. So that's why I'm really excited about this BRAF urine mutation test. You know, any veterinarian can do it. It's now exclusively, as of spring of 2019, available through Antech Diagnostics. And I'm going to tell you about that test in the rest of the video. So before I tell you about the BRAF test, I am going to just let you know that there's a lot of information about this, and Antech, as I mentioned, is the lab that's running it. So we're going to put a link below for, you know, some common frequently asked questions about it, about how much urine you have to have, how to collect it, and things like that. I hope that you'll find that helpful. The BRAF mutation urine test is possible because of Dr. Breen, who worked out this mutation, and he's at NC State. So there's a mutation in dogs called the BRAF mutation, and this mutation in their genes results in an overactive protein, the BRAF protein, which is involved in the cancer process. And this urine test has been able to detect that, and that is the basis of the BRAF mutation test. They have been able to find this in urine, and it has been used as a molecular marker. It is a droplet digital PCR test, and it is a DNA-based test. What I like about it, it's non-invasive. So again, you know, your dog is just peeing and we're collecting that urine. It actually is best if it's a free catch urine. So not actually one that often when we're collecting urine for a urine culture, we'll do something called a cystocentesis, where often done ultrasound guided, where we'll use a needle and syringe and collect that urine sterilely from the bladder. This actually is gonna be a better test if we do free catch urine, and it could be multiple samples collected over multiple days, because we want those cells that are sloughed into the urine. Like I said, it is a highly sensitive test. It's been validated in hundreds of cases, you know, into dogs that have benign conditions, chronic inflammatory conditions, urinary tract infections. One of the previous tests that had been on the market, the bladder tumor antigen test, you couldn't run if the pet had inflammation or protein or white blood cells in the urine, which didn't really work well because most of these dogs that have bladder cancer also have very active urine samples. So they have white blood cells and protein and blood in the urine. So then you couldn't run this other test. So with this urine test, they can have all this other stuff in the urine, and it still makes the test very accurate. So how accurate is the test? So there's two parts to the test. First, they run the BRAF assay, looking for the mutation. If that is undetected, they will automatically run an algorithm and then do the plus assay. When you put those two tests together, the sensitivity increases to 95%. So for the first test, it's 85% and then increases to 95%. What does that mean? That means statistically, there's only a 5% chance of a dog with clinical signs having one of these cancers, transitional cell carcinoma, cancer of the urothelial tract, of the urinary tract, that they haven't been able to find. So only 5% chance that they missed it with this test. If the test is positive, there are no false positives. You can be confident that the test was accurate. That is a pretty amazing test, in my humble opinion. There are gonna be some cases where they will run the first test, the BRAF test, and then based on their algorithm, they might not be able to run the plus assay, and then the sensitivity is 85%. So there's a 15% chance that they missed the diagnosis. So again, a little bit confusing. Talk it over with your veterinarian. If you're a veterinarian and you have any questions, you know, let me know as well. I am gonna be lecturing on this throughout, the upcoming year. I also have an article about it that we'll put a link below that I wrote for DVM 360 recently as well. So very exciting. I've been using this test not only for diagnosing, but also for monitoring my patients as they're going through chemotherapy to see if they're responding well. So I've been using it for both my prostatic carcinoma and my bladder transitional cell carcinoma. So not only a diagnosis test, but also a case, you know, for monitoring. When they finish chemotherapy, you can use it as a monitoring test to see if the cancer is relapsing as well. So I'm really excited about that. Like I said, I've been using it in practice for the probably last 2 years, and I'm really excited about it because it's non-invasive, and I think it just really has a really good role for these urothelial carcinomas. So again, thanks so much for watching. I hope you found it helpful. I know the statistics get a little bit mind-boggling. Maybe you need to go back and replay that. If I didn't explain something well, let me know. I will be following up with another video soon about bladder cancer, just summarizing some of the different treatment options. But like I mentioned, it is a treatable cancer, but early detection is going to help our pets. So let's find this cancer earlier. Let's use these screening tests. Let's know which patients are at risk. Be sure to go back and watch the last video as well. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you at the next video.